Hello and welcome to St. Margaret Lothbury. My name's Will. It's my pleasure to lead us in worship today from our church here in the heart of the City of London. So why don't you join with me as we worship.
Thank you. unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. 'Cause I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. 'Cause I'm no longer a slave. I am a child of God. A child of God. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Yes, love has called my name. I've been born again to your family. Your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Child of you, God. Oh, how you love us, Lord. How you love us. God. Yes, I am a child of God. Since I am a child of God.
Yeah.
would you come? Ooh. Would you come? Would you come?
Yeah, Lord, we're desperate for more of you. We're desperate for an encounter with you today, Lord. Would you pour your Spirit out upon us? Lord, we pray. Lord, we know that you long to meet with us and that you have good gifts for us. So we just want to say that we are waiting, we are expecting.
Spirit come, Spirit fall fresh on us.
Today's reading is taken from Ephesians chapter 3, verses 14 to 21. A prayer for the Ephesians. For this reason, I kneel before the Father, from whom his whole family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the saints to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus, throughout all generations, for ever and ever. Amen. Thanks be to God.
May I take this opportunity of repeating the welcome that Will gave you earlier. And thank you, Will, for leading us in worship. Thank you, Bridget, for reading that extract from Ephesians to us. It's great that we're able to meet like this. And wherever you are and whenever you watch this, you are very welcome, and thank you for joining us. I don't know about you, but I often think that I pray most enthusiastically for the things that matter most to me. I, of course, pray for a whole lot of things, people in different parts of the world, situations that people have asked me to pray for, but I do notice that when I'm praying for something that I'm really committed to, there is a passion in my prayer life. And it's very interesting to see that in some small way, when I pray passionately, I'm reflecting how the apostle prayed for those Ephesian Christians 2,000 years ago. He starts, as we heard earlier, by saying, for this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and earth derives its name. Any first century Jewish person would stand in order to pray, to kneel, or actually, as this probably means us to understand, he was down, flat on the floor, on his face, praying passionately to God for the Ephesian Christians to whom he was writing. He was full of commitment to them and praying passionately for them. And he was praying for one thing in particular, which we heard in that last verse that was read to us earlier, that they might come and know the fullness of God. It's one of those enigmatic Pauline sentences where you think, it sounds great, but what actually does it mean? And as far as I can see from what very clever people have written, it is simply Paul saying in a wonderfully poetic way, I want you to be more like Jesus Christ. And I am passionate in my prayer for you, the more and more you will be like Jesus. And he goes on in the verses between those, the first and the last verses read, to highlight two areas that he knew he wanted the Holy Spirit to work in order that they might become more like Jesus Christ. He wanted the Holy Spirit, firstly, to strengthen them with power in their inner being. He wanted the Spirit to go deep in the work that he was doing in their lives. And particularly, he wanted the Holy Spirit to encourage them and steady them in the face of those things which might discourage those Ephesians. They realized that sometimes their prayers weren't answered very quickly. They failed again to resist that temptation that they'd fallen to all so often in the past. They didn't see any interest in their friends and neighbors when they spoke to them about their Christian faith. Sometimes they got really discouraged in the middle of their Christian walk. And Paul is saying, I want the Holy Spirit to go really deep into your lives and ensure that when things aren't as you'd want them to be, when you kick yourself for having made a mess of it, that actually you're steady enough not to feel defeated by that situation. So I want the Holy Spirit to go deep and to steady you. And the second was that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And in saying dwell, he uses a word which is saying, this isn't some temporary relationship. This isn't an arrangement that is time limited in some way. This is going to last for eternity. Jesus Christ is not going to walk away from you, no matter what happens, no matter how much you let him down, no matter how often you fail. He's in it for eternity. He's not going to give up. And he doesn't want you to live anxious that he might just get fed up with your constantly getting things wrong. I'm passionate, says Paul, when I pray about you, passionate. The more and more you'll become like Jesus Christ, be filled with the fullness of God. But he says, I want the Holy Spirit to do some deep work to make sure that journey towards being like Jesus, however slowly it happens, is one from which you're never deflected. And it makes you and me say, and I wonder today, what characteristic of Jesus do I want to see more of in my life? Am I being honest with him in prayer, saying, please send your Spirit, because when this happens or that happens, I so easily get discouraged. I so easily fear that you're going to give up on me. And when we ask, Jesus responds and sends his Holy Spirit.
Your rallying hope.
Pray now, Father, that you would come by your Spirit, that you'd fill us afresh, that you would encourage us by your commitment to us, that you'd show us your agenda of how we need to change. Would we understand that you are as passionate about us as Paul was about his contemporaries. Just come, I pray. Come and bless us.
You make me brave. You make me brave.